Ragnarok was Lupino's private nightclub, a den of drugs built into an old theater. I knew what waited inside. V-head junkies ready to explode in random acts of senseless violence, and Lupino's goon squad, the worst stone-cold killers this side of hell. Ragnarok was as inviting as a headache, flickering and flashing to a machine gun beat. The belly of the nightclub was a gothic theme park that began with bondage games and led to the nasty stuff from there. As subtle with its dark message as a cop killer bullet through the heart, like father, like son, just like Jack Lupino. Book had never been a bestseller. Given the setting, I was surprised to find that somebody had been passing time reading. The paperback was entitled The Age of Murder and Storm. The blurb on the back mentioned Norse mythos and Ragnarok, the end of a Viking world with a terrible winter that covered the earth in ice, when vile crimes were rampant and all humanity lost. I could see how somebody impressionable might get it into their head that we were at the end of time. I was also beginning to see what the nightclub and its owner were all about. And the occult had been piled on the table. The room was stacked with light reading, such as Necronomicon, Witchcraft, and Paradise Lost. Old, exotic titles like Malleus Maleficarum and De Umbrarum Rani Novum Portus. Books with pentagrams on their covers, all dealing with the occult and the infernal, lying between stacks of horror videos and a couple of Ouija boards. The only thing I could take seriously was the thought of Lupino taking it seriously. He had been spending a lot of time getting intimate with the guy downstairs.